Hello, this is Bern, and if you've ever wondered how to express what you really want to a man without feeling needy, well, you're in luck, because that's what you and I will discuss today. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetv.com. Today is another edition of Get the Love You Crave, and today what you and I will be discussing is how to express what you really want and need and crave from a man without actually feeling needy. And the first thing I'll say is that most women have learned to do this primarily through demanding something from a guy. Namely, stating an ultimatum, like, you do this or else I'm out, right? And the reason why that usually is the wrong approach is because although in the short term, some guys might actually step up to the plate and say, I'll do this, they'll deeply resent you for it. They'll feel energetically like their freedom is being taken from them because it's not something that they actually crave. They actually have to. They were put in between a rock and a hard place and they had to make a choice. Sometimes out of fear, they make the choice of giving you what you need, but because they resent it, they stop giving it to you long term, or they do the opposite. So what's a better alternative? A better alternative is to actually speak your truth. But speaking your truth comes from a place of being completely detached, and here's what I mean. The first step in you being able to create what you want from a man, asking for what you want without feeling needy, is understanding that at the end of the day, if the guy is unwilling or unable to give you what you want, you are going to be just fine. You will be completely great because you can create that intimacy and that connection with someone else if this person chooses not to step up to the plate the things that really matter to you most. Okay? So if you are acting from this place of detachment, not because you don't care about the guy, but because you care a lot about yourself and because you have so much self-love that you know that you can create the kind of relationship you want, whether this guy wants to give it to you or not, then you're a lot more likely to step number two, which is speak your truth from a place of desire. And here's how I recommend doing this. The best way to start talking about what you need from a guy is to ask him an open-ended question so he can tell you first how he feels that same thing. So for example, let's say that you have a deep need for someone to let you know that he loves you physically by touching you a certain way or by telling you, I love you, and that's not happening, right? So a way would be like just demanding it, which we already discussed is not a good idea. The other way would be, let's say that you tell the guy you're in a very good state emotionally, face-to-face. It's not via text, not via Facebook, not via email. You're with the man and you say, well, I love to understand, how do you actually feel most loved in life? What are the things that a woman does that makes you feel loved? If you're the woman already in the relationship, say, what are the things I do that make you feel most loved? And let him speak freely so you get a chance to understand two things. One, what is his strategy for experiencing love? But two, are you actually doing those things for him? Because if you're not doing those things for him, before going to step number three, you have to first start filling up his emotional bank account so you can actually request what you want. So if you have not been filling up his needs the way he wants them, you make notes and then you start doing that. If he says, I want to be touched a certain way, I want to be told this way, when you show up and you are so happy and alive, that makes me feel loved, you start doing that for a few days. And then you come back to the conversation and say, well, I love to explain to you, express to you how I actually feel loved. And then you express, well, I really feel most loved when you tell me clearly that you love me. And he might actually, if you've actually done these things where he starts feeling love, he's going to be a lot more willing to actually do it than if you just demanded it. Or for example, let's say that you want a deeper level of commitment and it's not happening. Another way to do this, speak your truth, would be to say, I would love to understand, what are you looking for in a relationship? What are you looking for out of this? Where do you see yourself a year from now? And let him speak and let you hear what he's saying and what he's not saying in terms of what he really wants. When he says that, then you say, well, this is where I see myself a year from now. A year from now, I love to be in this and this and this position. If that's engaged, say engaged. I love to be planning a family. Now, you're not saying you have to be that man. You're basically, because you have that level of attachment where if he's not willing to be that guy and that's what you really want, then you're basically letting him know, well, it's okay if you want to be that man. Step up and do that for me. But if you don't, that's where I'm going. That's where I'm heading. So in this way, because you're detached, you're not demanding it from him, you're giving him the opportunity to step up and say, you know what, I want to be that man for you. I want to provide you with the things that you want. Or he knows in his heart that he very clearly risks losing you because what you want is something that's clear to you and you're not needing it from him if he's not willing to give it. You're free. You're letting him be free and decide on his own that he wants to step up to the plate and be your man. I hope this is helpful. And I also want to share this with you. If for any reason at all you are not yet on my email list where I get to share a lot more stuff than what I share on Facebook, what I share on YouTube, then I highly suggest that you click on the link below right now, sign up for this list where you get a free video series titled 3 Bulletproof Habits to Get the Man You Want in 90 Days or Less. If you are already on my list and you're watching this on YouTube, simply click on the like button for this video, write a comment below, and also subscribe to my channel so that you can continue receiving these videos on your newsfeed. Thank you so much for allowing me to share this with you, and as always, I challenge you to live a full, a conscious life.